middle school, I was a straight A student, and when I got suspended for making a video with my friends, just joking around, that the school thought it was inappropriate, they suspended me, and I literally lost everything that I had. I was supposed to be valedictorian, and I lost that, and since then, I have never gotten an A in class.
We had a situation in our school where students were giving truancy tickets, and I was one of them. And instead of talking to like a counselor about it, a police officer just gave me a ticket without even asking why I was late. And I was only late 5 minutes. So I don't think it was appropriate for me to get a ticket and place that burden on my family. And I know I'm not the only one, because thousands and thousands of these tickets have been given out to students around the area. So I would prefer to have a counselor, someone that I could talk to and just, you know, tell them how I feel and things like that, but we don't have that privilege in our school.
I've heard a lot of crazy examples. I think the one that was in the media most recently, actually this ended up with an expulsion. It's some kid spitting out a bus window, right? And the spit landed on somebody in the next car with a convertible. And they took it to the nth degree and had the kid arrested for battery and expelled from school because he was on a school bus when he did it. So I think that kid obviously made a bad choice, right? But did he make the choice? Was that choice severe enough that the rest of his life should be so drastically affected?
There was a huge lack of communication, because every single time you're at school, and this is the way I see it, I'm big, you're small, I'm smart, you're dumb. And so it's like they're the older people and they don't give a rat's behind of what you think.
It affects their self-esteem. It affects their connectedness to the community, and it decreases their chances of succeeding in school, because they're not in school, they're in suspension or expulsion. And then that decreases their opportunities for meaningful employment, going on to college, things like that. And ultimately, the way that they end up trying to survive, you know, food, shelter, clothing, the way that they get money to do that ends up being with criminal activities. And if those are the only options available, starving or committing a crime, I think even I would commit a crime.
I got involved because I saw a lot of things that I didn't like in my school. For example, seeing a lot of my friends get ticketed, I didn't like that, so that was an issue, so a lot of teachers and students rallied up. We organized and we went to City Hall and we amended the law. So, you know, that's another example that change does happen if we all come together. And we come together if we are all informed. And students become informed when they go to school, and they go to school if they don't fear getting a ticket.